morning. This is Clifftop 2015, and we're going to have a lesson for Edwin today about life-changing banjo chords in the key of double C. So when you're playing along with rags and C-tune, even non-rags, just C-tunes, I'm going to just demonstrate first, and then I'll go and break it down each chord. So on the fifth fret, you kind of ignore for these closed chords the fifth string. So you put your, on the first and third string, your pinky and ring finger, and then the second and first. You make a parallelogram. You just think in terms of shapes. So the C, the one is. And the G is a triangle that involves the pinkies in the same spot. The ring finger goes down to the, so all three are on one fret, and there's a triangle with the index finger on the third string, and that's your G7. And you go back to the parallelogram. Daddy long legs, sorry. So that's a G7, right? So you move up two frets, and that's your A7. And then if you keep your pinky there, but you drop the little triangle down one fret, that's your D7. Now your pinky catches up, and they all slide back one fret back to the G. And then back to your parallelogram. Let's go back up. A7. G7. So that's your circle of fifths. So another thing is the F chord. If you're playing in the key of C, you often need your F. So, and then you bar the fifth, and then you put your pinky on two frets up on the first string. That's your F7, I guess, or F. And then you go back, usually it's to a G. Oops. I have my wrong glasses on. Thing called the F turnaround at all. I'll show in a second, but just to introduce it, it sounds like this. So to go over that again, you're barring at the fifth fret with your pinky on the two frets up. And your pinky drops down one. That's so called F minor or F, mm-hmm. Natural F, and then you go to the G, the triangle, remember, with your upper finger on the third string. Oops. Wait, let me just do that. Yes.
Well, that's nice.
So this will change your life, I promise you, in a C jam. If you know these chords, now I have to give full credit to Mick Kinney, my mentor in Atlanta. So he showed me this. And these are, because they're sevens, each of these chords, you're going to get this driving, like the guitars are doing the major chords and you're doing the sevens, you're going to create this drive around the circle of fifths that makes people not want to stop. And that's important. They should play, well, rags for a long time. So anyway, common like Stone Mountain Wobble. So just kind of walk through the chords for the Stone Mountain Wobble. The A part is just going from C to G. The hardest part is just getting that parallelogram,
mm-hmm.
For the C. Just to get your fingers comfortable with that position. And then all alternating back to the G. I would start with that, just getting familiar alternating between C and... Because once you have that,
There's one that's exactly like that on the uke.
Oh, really? So,
yeah. Nice.
And you can translate... I have a little YouTube of this doing banjo mandolin chords. They have the similar... It's just with the triangle and the way the triangle moves. But this is... So any questions before we cut the film? Let me see what else is there. I know you can do this also when you're doing an F tune. You'll just start... But I can't remember the B flat. But when I do that, we'll make another video how to do F tunes in this.
Okay.
All right. So now.